Shoo my friendly eye and welcome back to my channel. My name is CaitlinAnwyn for anyone who's new here, and let's get back into building in Planet Zoo. And today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. We're going to do a mix of station building, which is what we're starting with here for the riverboat ride, and then we're going to do a little bit of a bonus build at the end for some pygmy hippos. Thought it'd be nice to mix it up a little bit and do a bit of station building and a bit of habitat building, so it's not all like exactly the same, and it makes it a little bit more fun for me as well because I love building habitats. And I mentioned in the last video I seen these weathered wood pieces from the Africa pack, and I thought they would be perfect for building like a little boathouse or like a boat shack because they look very weathered. It kind of reminded me of a little boathouse in the game Tell Me Why that I played last year on my channel, and I really really loved that game. And when I was thinking about boat kind of things, that was the first thing that pops into my head, was that little boathouse at the end of this little pier. Something significant happens by this like boathouse, and that's what I pictured. It's this weathered, abandoned boathouse. Even though this building doesn't really fit in with the style of the other buildings that we've got in this zoo, this still feels like it could belong anywhere. And the like wooden brown colours still matching quite nicely with like the browns and beiges in the fall colour scheme. But I really like this because of the weathered effect, but I didn't like any of the panels, which would have made my job so much easier. I really liked how these wooden planks looked more than the panels. The panels still have like weathering, but these planks are four-sided, so I could rotate four of them every way, so there would be a variation. But it really felt like I was building this. Instead of just placing walls, I really felt like I was building this plank by plank. This took a lot longer than I would have liked. Especially because I was rotating each piece one way, so it wasn't an exact pattern and your eye couldn't see the repeating pattern as easy. It's something that I notice more than anything. I always notice like slight differences or matches with things. I'm especially quick at finding like odd spelling mistakes. I've mentioned before, I really enjoy reading, and I can spot a spelling mistake in a book almost immediately because it just looks wrong. And having like these patterns and having it repeat too much looked wrong. I don't even know how to explain it. I can't be the only one that like feels like this. So I was just trying to cover the metal with all of the wood pieces, but I still kind of went around certain parts to have it look similar to the station itself, just to hide the metal parts as well. So I used the thinner round wooden pieces as like little crosses to support the structure and to reflect what the station itself looks like. But yeah, I really really enjoyed playing Tell Me Why last year. I'd really like to play another story based, choice based game like that again. I'm just kind of like sat up here on my own playing games, and yeah, I can like watch things or put like a podcast on, listen to music while I'm building, but I can kind of feel a little lonely. Like YouTube is kind of like a lonely thing to do unless you're collabing with people, and even then like that's not often, is it? And I have no friends, so I can't collab. The story-based games makes you feel like you're kind of playing with someone else in a way. Like you get to listen to characters' stories and it feels like you're playing with them rather than on your own. The only time I actually feel like I'm talking to someone is when I reply to comments and stuff. That's fun. I love having comments and chatting to people that way. That's when I truly feel like I'm actually talking to people. But like this, it doesn't feel like I'm actually talking to someone at all. Probably why I'm so at ease chatting like this, because I have like crippling social anxiety and I can't actually really talk to people. Sometimes I just wanna be able to like follow someone else's story. And I was having a look and I found that the next Life is Strange game, Life is Strange 3, is releasing in September, I think. I haven't technically played any of the other Life is Strange games on this channel, but I have played them before I created this channel. I think I might have a go at playing Life is Strange when it comes out. Might be fun to mix it up a little bit. I probably won't stop playing Planet Zoo. I might do like a mix, but I really love Life is Strange because it's LGBTQ plus storylines, kind of like Tell Me Why. But yeah, they are magical as well and kind of a little bit fantasy too. It's not super realistic, and that's the type of books I love to read. But yeah, let me know if you're into Life is Strange, if you've played or watched the other Life is Strange games, and whether you'd like to see that on the channel. Might do it anyway. And once I was happy with the shape of the boathouse, boat shack, I don't really know what to call it, I then needed to make sure that I had like doorways for the guests to get in and out of this station building. Oh, I had too much fun creating and then I was like, oh shit, yeah, they can't get in. So I just duplicated the back of the building to the front of the building. Because these things take so long, I will always try to find a way to make things quicker and easier. Work smart, not hard. And I was also planning on making this like a part of the habitat shelter as well. So I wanted to do a little bit more of a roof piece, like a little porch in this area. But the pygmy hippos couldn't actually get to this boathouse part to class that as shelter. I kind of liked how the roof looked like that anyway, in that little porch. And I just duplicated it over to the second stop. This stop's gonna be for the regular hippos, like the regular sized hippos. And I was thinking of doing like a little sign for the boathouse, for like the boat ride. The lettering and the signage is very clean and perfect looking, and wasn't really going with the style. But what you would really want to keep perfect is a life ring. Something that if someone fell in the water, you'd still need a new life ring. I think they're life rings. Life boy, life ring boys. Like a floaty. But that would need to be kept new and clean and be replaced when it got weathered, because that's something to save someone's life. So I used the shapes and added in some of that new rope from the Africa pack, because that was colored instead of having like the natural rope color. I really like the colorful rope. Find any excuse to use that. And the automatic color for the rope is orange, so it goes quite nicely with the ring as well. And now onto the pygmy hippo habitat. I did promise we'd do a little bit of a habitat build as well. And I really like how these little islands look. I did lower the water down a tad from the pre-terraformed map. That is always going to be in the description of the video as well. The links to the video and the link to the blueprint. But I did lower the river down a little bit so we could have more land in the middle and have like a little island. You can see where the null barrier is. Behind that then there's more land and more island space for the hippos, like the regular sized hippos. And I also wanted to do something like a little bit of a tropical island feel to this. I played around with the plants a little bit, made it a little bit more tropical feeling, having some of these like palm trees They might be African date trees as well. I can't remember where I placed now. It was like a toss-up between the hippos and the pygmy hippos for this habitat, and I just thought these were so cute. I wanted to give them a habitat. But I was struggling with adding a shelter in for them as well. Shelters are just so tricky. I'm tempted to just switch off animal happiness or whatever. I'm tempted to switch it off so I don't have to make them completely happy. I can play around with the sandbox settings and just switch that off and just make habitats however I want to make them. But on the other hand, some people might want to download these habitats for theirs and they might not want to switch off their like animal happiness, or I can't remember the word now. They might not want to switch that off, so I do want to make sure that these habitats are usable. So I just grabbed the station building that I built for the first part of this speed build series. Instead of having like the doors for the entrance at the side where the guests' pathways are, I thought I would use those little entrances for the hippos and have the back of the building towards where the guests' pathways are. So it's not exactly the same building then, it's two different looking buildings in the same style. I didn't want the habitat gate to look odd though and just have like a big hole. I did play around with like some of the plaster pieces and try and build a frame for the door, because these buildings are a little shorter than regular wall height, so the regular door frames didn't fit in, so I had to use some extra little panels and try and blend them in nicely with the building itself. And of course I made sure that the hippos can actually get into this habitat and the keepers can get in. The door works perfectly fine. Actually got that idea from one of the zoos that I took a tour around a couple of months ago, the city zoo that had a lot of buildings integrated into the habitat entrances, which I found really interesting. And it looks really nice, like it ties in those staff buildings as well. Thankfully it makes it look like another little town in this corner. I really like it. And that's pretty much it. This is a nice little variation for like a video. It's not like a whole habitat building video and it's not a whole station building video. It's a mix of both and it was nice to mix it up a little bit. I think the pygmy hippos look at home in this little building as well. And the way I've built it lets in a lot of like air and sunlight too, which is really pretty. I love the way the sun streams through the cross-hatched wooden pieces and adds like extra little shadows in. It fits really nicely in with that area as well. Yeah, it's a little bit of like a tropical island, but the habitat like is tied in a bit more with the rest of the zoo with that building. But let me know what you think. Do you like having like a mix of the two, or would you rather just stick to one sort of theme at a time in a video? And of course let me know what other animals you would like to see me build habitats for this zoo, and any sort of ideas of what kinds of habitats you would like me to build for them as well. I love all of your suggestions and your comments. I love replying to people too. It's so much fun like getting the interaction as well. Like I said, this can get a little lonely. And let me know whether you're excited for the new Life is Strange game as well. Life is Strange 3. I'm super excited for it. It's getting super close now. I'm really looking forward to playing something a little different on the channel as well. Kind of like Tell Me Why. And if you haven't seen my playthrough of Tell Me Why, I will put it up in the iCards. And I'm gonna leave it off there. That was fun. If you enjoyed this video, smash that like button. And if you haven't already and you would like to, it would mean a lot to me if you could subscribe. And hit the bell to be notified whenever I upload a new video. I upload on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.